这个谜团要解开是到底为什么会有特勤局允许这样的事情被发生呢？我们先不谈到底为什么他们没有在事先就封锁这个枪手所在的制高点，先来看呢是在枪声响了之后特勤局的反应。有人就数了一下，发现特勤花了整整两分钟才把川普带下台。就这位曾经在 FBI 工作过的专业人士就说了，假如这个枪手呢他不是孤狼犯案，他有同伙的话，有第二名枪手的话，那川普早就已经死了。而且这个涉及的位置我们刚提到离讲台很近，110到120公尺，假如这个枪手他的射术比较好一点的话，那可能很容易就可以涉及到任何一个他想射中的目标。所以现在外界都开始检讨特勤局，你是不是在专业上没有继续精进，甚至呢完全疏忽呢？很多人就质疑这个特勤局的局长，认为呢维安这么失职，你是不是要请辞下台来以示负责呢？认为这位局长上任之后花太多时间在做 DEI， 要多元，要公平，要包容，不过没有去检讨一下我们的本业，我们要保护重要人士这样的重责大任到底有没有好好的来执行。那另外现场其实也有这个 FBI 的人员在场，所以有人认为 FBI 是不是也应该要负责呢？不过他们就解释，他们的人在场只是负责支援的，是特勤局在主导维安计划，这两个是完全不同的单位，所以认为呢还是要特勤局出来说清楚讲明白。所以确实现在这个众议院的议员呢就说了，已经联系特勤局希望他们来做报告，也要求这位特勤局长需要出席听证会，要做一个事后的大检讨。那当然不幸中的大幸是川普本人没事，只是耳朵受伤。不过川普的粉丝呢，当时台下非常多人，那其中这一位呢是川普的铁粉，他听到枪声之后想要保护跟他一起来参加造势的妻子跟小孩，就转身背面面向呢这个枪手射击的位置，结果后脑勺中弹不治身亡。那川普呢事后在接受访问的时候也说，这位粉丝是大英雄。
群众大叫，指着看台一方，要大家快点来救人，因为有支持群众遭流弹波及受伤。川普造势遇上暗杀，唯一不幸的罹难者就是他在台下参加造势的50岁消防队员康佩拉托尔。
I just wish it didn't happen. I just can't believe it happened. Truly a good.God-fearing, hard-working man, loved his family.
同事语带哽咽，不敢置信。据传当时康佩拉托尔和妻子、女儿出席活动，混乱下他扑倒家人，结果子弹刚好打到他的后脑勺。
We also extend our deepest condolences to the family of the victims who was killed. Corey was a husband, a father, a volunteer firefighter, a hero, sheltering his family from those bullets.
美国总统拜登也赞赏他是一位英雄，不过亲友不敢相信参加造势居然会遇上死劫。
Major loss. Like I've stated, he's a man that give the shirt off his back to anyone. I mean, in his last moments, he was shielding his family from the gunfire.
同事拿出旧照，回忆起他的过往。他也是一名忠实川粉。
If Corey was standing behind Trump, and he was on the bleachers behind him when he got murdered, saving his family, I'm going to be voting for this man. If only for Corey.
共和党人当然趁着这时候大力称赞自家候选人。
President Trump knew exactly the risk he was taking, running for re-election. He realized his life would be at risk because President Trump loves this country.
即便面对枪手企图暗杀川普，仍处变不惊。这起枪击案已经为这次美国大选投下极大变数。TVBS 新闻总导。
确实大家都在问接下来美选会如何的发展呢？我们先来看，这是华盛顿观察家报在事后对川普做了一个专访。川普呢就回顾了当下的情况，他说呢要撤离的时候，他之所以会握拳高喊战斗，是因为他想让群众知道他其实没有事，那他会继续的前进。因为毕竟枪击案对他来讲很不公平，他知道全世界都在看，历史会自作评断，他想要证明的是他们没事，会继续 坚定的、坚强的来往前进。那当然，这个局面对拜登来讲，其实呢就比较不利了，因为焦点全部都在川普的身上。这个时候呢，也不好继续去批评他，必须要展现自己的人道关怀。所以拜登呢，在第一时间也马上来谴责这个攻击，打电话给川普阵营来问候。那也发表一个全国谈话，希望呢社会的对立能够降温，也承诺呢会请有关单位赶快来调查，而且呢尽快的来公布结果。所以对拜登来讲，现在似乎呢不是一个采取对骂、互相攻击战的这个好的时机点，希望让选民用政绩来聚焦呢他对美国的贡献。那另外的一个问题是呢，这个枪击案发生的地点在宾州。宾州一直都是摇摆州，今年的选情其实呢也还蛮不确定的，所以现在呢发生枪击案，恐怕拜登更难对宾州的选民说服他们把票投给民主党，所以这一仗恐怕还是蛮难打的。或是我们用历史的这个事件来看，在1981年呢雷根遇刺，不过共和党当时的其中选举呢还是失利的，也没有讨到任何一点的好处。所以学者就分析认为呢，这次的枪击案恐怕有一个趋势是确定的，就是独立选民会变得越来越多，他们的声音可能会变得比较大声。那纽约时报的分析则是认为，现在大家都在想要找战犯，有很多的愤怒或是焦虑的情绪在，所以这很可能会继续撕裂美国的社会。
险遭暗杀的美国前总统川普，隔天按原计划抵达威斯康星州最大城密尔瓦基。下机途中，他停下脚步，再度多次振臂握拳。本周，他将在这里正式被提名为共和党总统候选人。他接受《华盛顿观察家》报访问时透露，枪击案后他全面改写将在共和党全国代表大会发表的演说，希望用这历史性的一刻让全美甚至全世界团结起来，不再聚焦对手总统拜登的政策。
I'd like to have confidence in us as a society that we won't let things get out of control beyond what they already are.If we can just agree to disagree and then try to move ourselves forward.
美国总统拜登也在美东时间周日晚间八点的黄金时段，在白宫椭圆形办公室发表正式讲话，呼吁美国人团结，政治降温。
I want to speak to you tonight about the need for us to lower the temperature in our politics. And to remember, while we may disagree, we are not enemies. We're neighbors, we're friends, co-workers, citizens.And most importantly, we are fellow Americans. We must stand together.
这是拜登2021年上任以来第三次在椭圆形办公室发表重要谈话。这次距离11月5号大选不到四个月，而拜登自己的政治前途堪忧。拜登谈话六分多钟，美国主要新闻网包括保守的福斯新闻都进行直播。
There is no place in America for this kind of violence, for any violence ever. Period.No exceptions. We can't allow this violence to be normalized. You know, the political record in this country has gotten very heated. It's time to cool it down. We all have a responsibility to do that.
面对党内换败声浪的拜登，尽管一如往常说错几个字，但椭圆形办公室的讲话让他展现了现任总统的力量，也是他重要的象征性形象。
We used to say a president is president of all the people, not just the people who voted for him. We lost that along the way. We haven't had it for a while, but I think Biden is trying to fill that role and did a good job of it.
枪击案发生后，拜登阵营立刻撤下电视广告，暂停其他政治活动。拜登则返回白宫坐镇，下令对现场维安进行独立审查，并听取相关报告。
I'm just so grateful that former President Trump is okay. It's something that we have to process on this, and I don't think politics or blame or that kinds of who or this or that.This is just needing.
尽管两党议员大多避谈枪击案政治效应，呼吁团结、政治降温，但共和党籍众议院议长强生却把矛头指向拜登和民主党人。
When my colleagues go out, Democrat colleagues, and say democracy will end, the republic will be in an emergency.stage if Donald Trump wins for president. It's just not true. It's another election. And when they say that kind of rhetoric and they heat it up like that, there are people out there that take these things to heart and they act upon them.
不过根据路透社分析，2021到2023年200多件出于政治动机的暴力事件，致命的政治暴力多来自美国右翼而非左翼。
The issue here though is that we're living in the United States where there is significant support for political violence in the mainstream. What the messaging should do is not diminish the anger so much as re-vector the anger. And it should be vectoring the anger away from violence and toward voting.
根据追踪网络舆论公司数据，枪击案发生后几个小时内，社群上提到川普的次数是每日平均的17倍，当中不少表达同情或呼吁团结，但也有许多是毫无根据的说法或阴谋论。不过现在全美各地都有川粉站出来坚定力挺川普。
We know that they're trying to steal it from us, and they're going to do whatever they can to get rid of Trump. And so yesterday they tried, and so we're here to let them know that's not going to happen. We're not going to let that happen.
2024共和党全代会周一开幕，大会场地密尔瓦基的体育馆第一服务广场外已经可以看到大批警力进驻，周边也拉起维安封锁线。
So we are confident in these security plans that are in place for this event, and we're ready to go. It's been an 18-month process. We've worked together over that 18 months to develop operational security plans for any and all aspects of security related to this event.
尽管周六在宾州才发生枪击案，但美国特勤局表示全代会的维安计划不变，强调已做最高层级规划。体育新闻综合报道。
TVBS 新闻直播回到 YouTube 频道了，提醒您每周一到周五的晚间7点到9点，由新化主播为各位新闻化重点，记得一定要来参加直播。